Hey everybody, how's it going? So we're going to be doing the series of 2000 4Runner U-joint replacements for the drive shaft. So please stick around and I'll see you there. Thanks for watching. All right, everybody, this is going to be part two. We're going to be removing the drive shaft. See this. I already got it dropped. Sitting here on the ground. So we're gonna be removing it out of the transmission. Oh, they're not going to be able to see what I'm doing here. I'm just looking at the seal. This seal's pretty soft.
That's good, right?
19 years and the seal is still soft? Yeah, that's pretty good. Seal's really soft. It's pliable. Doesn't look like it's got any heat that's attacked it. Everything looks pretty good.
And this looks pretty clean too.
So, and I should have grabbed the other light, but the yoke portion is actually really nice and clean. It's got a couple grooves in it, but not horrible. Surprise, it hangs there. Is it on this? Is
yeah.
That what it's on?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Smooth. Doesn't feel like they're not gouges, they're just swirl lines.
Yeah.
So just a rundown of what I used to pull this out. I use a 14 millimeter gear wrench, a ratcheting gear wrench. I used a gear wrench 84 tooth flex head ratchet, a 1.5 inch extension, and a Carlisle 14 millimeter short socket. That's all I used. And I used a short Craftsman pry bar with the striker cap. So I think this is a 12-inch pry bar with 6-inch usable end. That's all I used to get it out. So, should be easy going back in. I did try a 10-pound mallet, or a 4-pound mallet, my bad. I just don't think I had enough striking room. Alright, so we're going to let this drip a little bit and we'll come back when we get it pulled out. Alright, so I'm going to be pulling it out now. It's done dripping. Camera out. Chowdery. This one's, they're both messed up. This one's kind of frozen. Now it's loose. This one's probably the worst one. Okay. We can go back to the truck. So I'm gonna clean the rear yoke, the mount. Thank you.
I just buffed it off. Alright.
And it's just a scour pad. It's a soft scour pad on the buffer. And it's the Earthquake XT 12 volt polisher that you can use for grinding. We're gonna go take the drive shaft apart.
You mean with the welder?
Oh, I know. You're going to need a flathead screwdriver.
And a hammer.
You said and a hammer.
Yeah. What's the view on the camera? Is it too close?
It's fine.
Come on.
Ow, something hit me.
There it goes. Here's the second one. Third one. Where is this one? It's right there. Come on. Stuck in there. All of them were easy, but the last one. Come on. There it goes. Okay. Also take out the grease fitting if it has a grease fitting.
Before you start knocking the U joint out.
Looks like an 8 millimeter. Cap stuck. enough space. Trying to get the cap to go up because the cap's kind of stuck. Give you guys a close up. Go get me a pry bar. I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna get it unstuck, and we'll continue the video.